Hello, I hope you've got Three Blind Mice down now well under your fingers. You've learnt it, play it fluently and competently. And now we're going to consider the options of chords we use for the harmonisation of that melody. Right, the first thing is to be certain that we know where repeated notes are based on the words of the song. The words and the syllables in the words are going to determine where notes are repeated or whatever. So I'm going to talk through the song and pick out where I'm going to decide to have repeated notes. So here we go then. Three blind mice. Three blind mice. See how they. Now how they is a repeated note. See how they. So on note four of the scale, I've got to repeat the note. See how they run. Repeat that phrase. See how they run. They all run. Now all run is a repeated note on note eight. They all run after the farmer's wife. Mer's wife is a repeated note on note five. She cut off there. Cut off there is three notes, three repeated notes on note eight. She cut off their tails with a carving knife. Ving knife is a repeated note on note five. Did you, that again is a repeated note on note five. Did you ever is a repeated note on note eight. Did you ever see such a sight in your life? In your life is a note repeated three times on note five. As three blind mice. Okay, so there we've decided on where the repeated notes are going to be. That's going to help me decide on, like I said, whether to use the same chord on each repeated note, which is not a good idea. More likely just play a chord and then a note on its own, or better still, to use two different chords on the same note. But we'll come to that at the appropriate time. Now then, for this part of the video of the harmonising of Three Blind Mice, I'm only going to do the first two phrases in this video, and then do the rest of the phrases in ensuing video. So the part of the song that we're going to harmonise is this. Three blind mice. Three blind mice. And that's as far as I'm going to go in this video, because we're going to look in detail at the options for harmonising those three notes of the melody and making it as interesting as we can. Okay, so here we go then. If you look on your chord sheet one, your resource sheet one, you'll see that the chord for harmonising note three is that sort of triangle shaped chord. And for harmonising note two, same shape chord, move down two frets, and for note one, that's the first chord on the sheet. So we'll go again, look. And then the phrase is repeated. Now then, applying the same idea of using different chords for the same note, we can actually use different chords for the same sequence of notes. So where a phrase is repeated, rather than repeating the same set of chords, we can change the chords to add variety and interest to the melody. So instead of just playing, time through, I'm going to use some different chords, and the other chords that we've come across and that we've learnt for these notes on the second string is the good old half diminished. So I'm going to use now the half diminished shape chord on note 3 and 2. Okay. Now, because that phrase is repeated twice, I'm going to use one set of chords the first time round and the other set of chords the second time round. So we get this. Adds interest, doesn't it? Same melody, same two phrases, but we've used two different sets of chords to do it, except for the first one, of course. The chord on note 1 was the same. The chords on notes 3 and 2 were different. There's another option, and I'm going to introduce another chord at this stage, a very, very nice chord that I haven't told you about before. Very easy to play and a very, very nice sounding chord on note 2. And on note 3, if you look at resource sheet 7 that I did for you, downloadable off my website, if we take the diminished chord that we're playing on note 3 and move the first finger down on the 5th fret, a semitone, instead of that sound, we get that sound. And that's what we call a major 7th sound. And as you recall from one of my previous lessons, where a melody begins on the 3rd note of the scale, the major 7th chord is a very nice chord to use. And particularly this shape when the melody note is on the top. So that's the chord I'm going to use now for note 3. Now the new chord for note 2. Place your first finger across the 3rd fret, all the strings on the 3rd fret, and put your second finger, your middle finger, on the 3rd string at the 4th fret. And play just the 6th string, the 4th string, the 3rd string, and the 2nd string. So we get that sound. Alright? So, major 7th chord on note 3. New chord for note 2. And then note 1. Once more, major 7th chord for note 3, new chord for note 2, and chord for note 1. Now, I've got three options now for playing those two phrases in. We're going to play the phrase twice because that's what the melody dictates, and I'm going to use two out of those three options for harmonising that first part of the melody. So here we go then. I'm going to choose the half diminished chords to begin with for notes 3 and 2, and then I'm going to use the major 7th chord and the new chord that I've just shown you for the second time round. So here we go then. Half diminished, half diminished, major chord, this time major 7th chord, new chord, okay, once more without me talking. Good, innit? Very, very simple. Using those ideas of harmonising the melody. Just three notes in the phrase repeated twice, using two sets of chords each time through. Okay? Now, we can actually embellish the melody a little bit. I'll just throw a bit extra in here to show you what I mean. Notice how I embellished the melody there. Listen again. Now, all I was doing there was playing the melody note with a chord, sliding the melody note up a semitone, and back a semitone, and down to the same note, putting the chord underneath it, sliding the melody note up to three again, back to two, added interest with the within the melody. Same time through using the major seventh chord. Nice, isn't it? Once more then, without talking, I'm going to use the major seventh, the diminished, the half diminished shape, two notes, there. Then I'm going to use the major seventh and the new chord and throw in a couple of the embellishments to make the melody line a little bit more interesting. Notice there also what I did in playing the chords with the melody note, particularly on the last chord. I played the melody note and then fed the accompaniment in underneath it. Listen once more to where I do there. Different set of chords. Okay, once more then, using the starting off with the half diminished. I won't speak this time. Okay, so just for those few simple ideas, we can turn a simple phrase of three notes repeated twice into something quite interesting to listen to. Okay, so we'll have a look at the next bit of the melody in the next video. Try out those chords for yourself. Try embellishing the melody in your way. Don't just try to copy my way. And arpeggiate the chords like I was doing there, or play them as block chords. Just experiment with it, make it as interesting as you want. Okay, so I'll see you on the next video for the next part of harmonizing Three Blind Mice.